guys, and welcome to YouTube channel. I'm Polinaroso. Before we continue, make sure you subscribe and you click the bell icon to enable notifications. So in this video today, I'll be showing you on how to slave a hard disk. Before you continue, slaving a hard disk means that's the process of adding a hard disk into your PC. So in my case, I'm going to slave in this desktop computer. So you must have two hard disks, slave and master. So whereby the master is the hard disk that the operating system will boot from. So in my case, this is my master hard disk. As you can see, it's of 500 gigabytes, and over here, this is my slave hard disk. As you can see, it's of 160 gigabytes. So I'm going to slave and proceed. So as I slave, first when slaving, make sure that the master hard disk picks SATA 0 or SATA 1 depending the type of your computer. So in my case, my motherboard, as you can see down here, over here you can see you have SATA 0 at this point, SATA 0. Then you come here, this SATA 2, as you can see there. So as you are going to slave, the master hard disk will pick SATA 0, then the slave hard disk will pick either SATA 1, SATA 2, or the rest. So let's go, let's continue. Again, that's just about that SATA transmits data to the two and from the hard drives. So again, over here you have the power for the hard disk. So let's connect. So when you look at the hard disk, you have the power part of it. Over here, this is the power. Then this is the point of data where the SATA picks from. So you connect the power. Then you connect another one over here. This now will be our master hard disk because it is originating from SATA 0. That's my master hard disk. So again, we're gonna slave the slave hard disk. So as you can see, slave hard disk will pick the following SATA. So again, you connect it over here, this point where it plays SATA. So SATA will pick this part here. There you go. Then the power, have the power over here. So again, pick the power, then place it over there. So just this is the simple way of slaving, and then make sure that you can place them at a very nice place so that they cannot interfere with the motherboard, because they can, if they slip on the motherboard, they may lead to destroying the component of the motherboard. So when you boot our PC, so our PC will boot from the master hard disk with the OS which is installed. So again, over about the slaving of the hard disk, so you also have what is called cloning. Cloning is now the process of copying information from the master hard disk to the slave hard disk. Information now is all the files, including the boot files. That's now cloning. If one full clone, you copy both the boot files and everything from that master hard disk, the slave. So in this process of cloning, ensure that the slave hard disk has capacity to hold the files from the master hard disk. So these are, you should clone. So make sure you subscribe to my channel and hit the bell icon to enable notifications. So my other videos that are about disassembling the PC, and others about more about hard disk, I'll find the link down in the description. Thanks for watching.